Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, I am going to explain you how you can use GoPro Max or any other 360 camera and create YouTube 360 or VR video. So without wasting time, let's get started. So here I am going to use the GoPro Max camera as I have the one. So first of all, copy your 360 video from memory card to your computer. So I already copied that 360 video file from the memory card. So as a next step, you need to open the GoPro Max GoPro player and click on the open media. Now select that 360 file. Now here you don't need to add any keyframes using this reframe icon, so you can trim the video if you want. So you can trim here video if you want, but you cannot use the reframing option. If you want to use this video as a 360 or VR video for the YouTube, so here I can trim this video and then go to the file and export option. Now here use the H.264 and for the resolution you can use any resolution you want, and without selecting any other options, just click on the next to export your video. So basically this will exporting the video and convert your .360 video to the mp4 file. So if you are using any other 360 camera like Insta360, then you need to use your that particular software to convert your 360 output into the mp4 format. So basically there is an individual app for each camera to convert their output to mp4 format. So you can use that applications based on your camera which you are going to use. So if you can see here, now we have the mp4 file, and now the problem is this mp4 file contains the 360 metadata, but that metadata is not as per the required format which is needed for the YouTube player to understand that this particular video is the 360 video. So for that we need one software. So I already provided that link in the description, so you can download software from here. So here you have the two options. If you are from the programming background, then you can use the source code and execute that, but this is basically the Python source code, so you can execute that source code and execute that particular Python file and inject your 360 metadata to the video. But if you are not from the background, then you can directly download that executable file based on your operating system. Now if you are using the Mac, I already downloaded the software. And if you are using the Mac, initially it gives you error, like unauthorized error, because the software is not from the registered Apple developer. So you need to go to the security preference and allow this software so that it can understood your it can allow you to open this application. Or either the another option is you can use that source code and execute on the command line and inject your 360 metadata to the video. So let's open this software. As I told you, for the Mac user you need to allow this application from the security preferences. For the Windows user there is no issue, you can open directly this application. Now by clicking on this open, select your converted mp4 file. So here you auto it will the software will automatically detect which type of video you have selected. So basically the my current video is the Spherical 360 video. So it opens, and now click on the inject metadata and store this file. So here we have the new mp4 file with the new name underscore injected. So basically what happened is this software will inject that particular 360 metadata which already exists in this particular our converted video into the format which required for the YouTube player. So now we have the new file, new mp4 file with the injected data. Now the next step is open your YouTube studio and click on the create and upload video. Now here select the file. Now here the one thing that you need to note is you need to select that mp4 file with the injected data. So that's you need to take care of. If you select this file which is converted from our GoPro player, then YouTube will not detect your video as a 360 video and it shows as a normal video. So you need to select this file. Now that's it. Now as per like other videos, you need to select other options and then I would recommend to mark it as unlisted until the progress is completed, like SD and HD process is completed, because sometimes YouTube will take time to inject, like understand that 360 metadata. So it is good to mark it as a unlisted, and once you will verify that its 360 metadata are rendered properly and it's what your video is working as a 360 video, you can change it, go to the video edit and you can publish it or schedule it based on your requirement. We will wait for till the video processing is complete. Okay guys, so as you can see here the HD processing is completed and HD processing is ongoing. So let's check if our 360 video is working or not. So here you can see that video is still being processed. Video quality may be improved once processing is completed, but here we can see that hand cursor. So that means our 360 video is rendering. I can change 360. I can see it. So that's it for this video. If you have any queries or any doubt related to this process or any other process, feel free to add your queries in the comment sections. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you need any other videos related, technical videos related to 360 videos, then feel free to add in the comment section. I will try to create a video ASAP and see you guys on the next video.